hallelujah, just to come in, and whether you wave your hands, whether you dance, shout, whatever, cry, you ain't got to worry about somebody judging you, looking at you crazy, whatever. Actually, we don't look at you crazy. Matter of fact, we encourage you. Yeah. You start praising, we might say, come on, come on.
Yes.
You just get excited about it. God is an awesome God. Hallelujah. Y'all just looking all nice and everything. Even we had to move our clocks ahead, y'all still looking away. Most of y'all.
Pastor.
Oh, God is good.
Yes,
God
is
good.
Yes, he is.
Man, Brother Dykus.
How you doing, Pastor?
Good to see you, man.
Yeah.
You must have heard me talking about you. Yeah, I don't know if my wife told you. Now, we just talked you up. Did she? Yeah, I just talked you up. Man, God is so awesome. Man, it's wonderful to see you. Man, it's so good. I'm glad you came and worshiped with us this morning. Hallelujah. Brother Dykus be out here, usually out here waiting on his children. You know, in the evening, usually when they're getting off the bus. And so about a year or so ago, I think I just, you know, started talking to him. I was like, that's a cool dude right there.
Yeah, he is.
I feel like we can be brothers.
For real? For real?
Yeah. Is that your brother?
Yeah.
It is, just from another mother, that's all. Oh, it's good to see you, amen. Good to see a visitor in the back. What's your name, young lady?
Antoinette.
Antoinette? Yeah, I like that name, it's a nice name. How you doing today?
Lovely.
Thank you for coming and joining us today. Anybody else visiting?
Nope.
Brother Skip, he's visiting. Brother Skip, you know, he's here today.
Hallelujah.
Actually, he might be back on the road.
Yes, I think so.
He's been coming pretty faithfully the last 2 weeks. No, God is good. Amen. We just like to have a little fun in the house of God. Good to see you. And Tracy, she's not visiting no more. So. You've been here before, you really ain't a visitor.
Amen.
You know, and once you get here once, we just love on you. And so we're huggers around here. If you,
amen.
We don't mean to scare you off, but we just like giving hug and love. Amen.
Amen.
So we hope that don't scare you. And we hope, you know, the liberty that we have doesn't scare you, but we don't apologize for the liberty in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
We're here to offer to God the praise and the best praise that we can give Him. Amen. But we're thankful for Pastor Alex.
Amen.
From the Ukraine being with us here. Hallelujah. I hope your name is Alex. Okay. Is it senior and junior, or is it one and two?
Either one.
Either one? So we're going to say Pastor Alexis. So yeah, we're thankful that they're here. I think you might have called me, I don't know, a few weeks ago or so. I don't know, a month ago. And said they'd be back in the States. And so, you know, they told me, asked me when I was coming to Ukraine. And so I said, well, I guess when you invite me. He said, well, you're officially invited right now. And I said, well, I was planning on maybe going to Uganda. I ain't going to make that this year. I'm planning on maybe go to Uganda next year. He said, well, you got to come to Ukraine before you go to Uganda. I said, all right. So I'm just warning everybody right now. I got two trips we got to go on next year. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Y'all going to let me go?
Amen.
Pray for them, pastors. Pray for them. You heard it got a little silent. I was like, amen, amen. Our God is good. So we just see. But we're going to move out of the way. They came to minister unto us today.
Amen.
We just have your freedom in God. Amen.
Amen.
Let's welcome Pastor Alex. Amen. And his son. Amen. Alex. Amen. 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 Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Hallelujah.
A wonderful worship.
Yes.
Yes.
Wonderful testimony. I love you, church. God bless you.
Thank you, Lord.
Next, I will preach in Russian. Да, я официально приглашаю вашего пастора в Украину.
Yes, I want to take an
an opportunity to invite your pastor officially to Ukraine once again, staying on the stage. So please support that trip and cover his that expenses financially.
Я рад, що ми маємо дружбу.
I'm really glad and rejoicing to have this friendship with your church.
Уже несколько лет.
For several years now.
Я думаю, що прийшло время пастору вашому посетити Україну.
So I believe this is a time for your this is really a time for your pastor to come and visit our church in Ukraine.
Ми хочемо продовжити строїти отношения.
Because we want to build this relation.
Amen.
Yeah, we want to improve it.
Любіть вашу церкву.
And you should love your church.
Будьте вірні вашій церкві.
And be faithful to your church.
Любіть вашого пастора.
Love your pastor.
Поддерживайте його руки, як Орі Арон.
Held up his hands like Joran Aaron.
Проще всього уйти в другу церкву.
You know, sometimes it seems the easiest way to leave and to just to attend another church.
Ну я вам скажу істину.
But I'll tell you the truth.
Нету совершенної церкви на землі.
There are no perfect church in this world.
І нет совершенного пастора.
And there are no perfect pastors in this world.
Совершенна церква на небі.
The only perfect church is on heaven.
І совершенний пастор це Ісус.
And the only perfect pastor or shepherd is Jesus.
Любіть вашу церкву, любіть пастора.
Love your church and love your pastor.
Молитесь за церкву.
Pray for your church.
Поститесь за церкву.
Take fast for your church.
Молитесь за пастора и его семью.
Pray for your pastor and for his family.
Поститесь за него.
You know, take a fast for him personally.
Устрояйте церковь, служите здесь.
Build this church. Build with your ministry, with your talents and gifts, whatever God gave you.
И ваша церковь будет лучше.
And then you're gonna see that your church will be better and better and better.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Его присутствие сейчас здесь.
And his presence is here now.
И Бог будет работать над тобой.
And God is going
сейчас.
To work with your heart this time now.
Он будет переводить тебя от веры
в веру. He is going to guide you from faith to faith.
От силы в силу.
He'll elevate you from power to power.
И от славы в славу.
From glory to glory.
Дух Божий будет говорить тебе.
Spirit of God is going to speak to you now.
Не я.
It's not me who's going to speak to you.
Но Бог будет говорить.
But God is going to speak to you
now. Amen.
Amen. And also I want to greet you from behalf of our church in Ukraine.
И поблагодарить вас за вашу поддержку в нашей работе в зоне войны.
And I want to take a chance to give you thanks and to say that I'm grateful for your support that you're giving to our church, to our ministry in Ukraine and at the war zone.
И ваша поддержка очень важна для нас.
Your support really important for us.
И вы самые лучшие даятели.
And you are honestly one of the best givers who support us.
Amen.
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 Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Do you have your Bible with you today?
Yes. Amen. Когда мы идем в Дом Божий,
you know, it's very important, whenever you go to the house of God,
мы берем с собой Библию.
To have your Bible
yes.
with you.
Тебе сразу сказал Амэн.
And everybody say Amen.
Amen.
Библия – это Слово Божье.
For a Bible is the Word of God.
That's right.
Библия, она исцеляет.
And it have a healing power.
Библия, она изменяет жизнь.
This book changed millions of lives.
В одной церкви пастор увидел, что одной пожилой сестры нету несколько воскресений.
I hear the story that this pastor, he realized that one old lady from his church, she just disappeared. She just didn't attend the church like for a month or so.
И он решил пойти посетить ее домой.
So he decided to attend her, to visit her at her home.
И он посидел, они сидели, пили
so
кофе,
he
общались.
Arrived at her home, she made some coffee for him, they had a fellowship.
И она говорит, пастор, я очень busy.
And she said, pastor, I'm very busy now.
У меня семья, у меня внуки.
I'm busy with my grandkids. I'm sitting with them all the time. I'm busy with my family stuff.
Он говорит, сестра, ты читаешь Библию?
And this pastor asked her a question. Do you read your Bible at least?
Она говорит, ну конечно, я же не язычница.
And she said, of course I'm reading the Bible. I'm not Gentile.
И она зовет свою внучку, говорит, Кэт, принеси мне Библию с помощью.
And to approve that, she decided to call her granddaughter. So she said, hey, Kathy, would you please bring me my Bible from my room?
И Кэти приносит толстую большую Библию.
And Kathy brought her that big Bible.
И сестра открывает Библию.
The sister opened that Bible.
И видит там ее очки.
And she finds her glasses there.
Она говорит: "Вау, я их уже полгода
ищу." And she said, "Oh, where is my glasses? I was looking for my glasses for 6 months now."
Oh, Lord.
I was trying to find my glasses 6 months now.
Oh, my God. 6 месяцев Библию не открывала.
That means she didn't even open her Bible for 6 months.
Yeah. Когда мы перестаем читать Библию?
No, when you if you stop reading the Bible.
Когда мы перестаем молиться?
If you stop praying.
О, нас пропадает желание идти в дом Божий.
Then you're also leaving your thirsty and your desire to come to the church with that.
Поэтому всегда пребывай в слове и в молитве.
It's very important to read your Bible on a regular basis and to pray.
Amen. Вы готовы слушать слово Божье?
Are you ready to listen to the word of God?
Hallelujah. Итак, давайте мы откроем Матфея 25 главу.
Let us open Matthew chapter 25.
Матфея 25 глава.
Matthew chapter 25.
Amen.
Очень интересная глава.
That is very interesting chapter.
В ней три притчи.
We can find three parables there.
О Царстве Небесном.
Jesus told three parables there about kingdom of God.
Первая притча о 10 девах.
And the first parable is about 10 virgins.
Вторая притча о талантах.
The second one is about talents.
И третья притча о овцах и козлах.
The third one is about goats and sheep.
И мы сегодня поговорим о первой притче.
But we're going to speak with you about first parable today.
И мы поговорим и тема моего послания неразумные девы.
And the title of my message is Unwise Virgins.
Возможно, ты уже 100 раз слышал об этом.
I can bet maybe you heard thousands or hundreds of sermons based on this parable.
И тысячу раз читал эту притчу.
Maybe you read this parable for 100 times.
Но сегодня Дух Божий будет по-особому говорить.
I believe the Spirit of God is going to speak to you today, this morning, in a special way.
Amen.
Amen.
И давайте мы будем читать с 1 по 13 стих.
So, I'm going to read verse 1 to 13. I'm going to read all of this parable. At that time, the kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. Five of them were foolish and five were wise. The foolish ones took their lamps, but did not take any oil with them. The wise, however, took oil in jars along with their lamps. The bridegroom was a long time in coming, and they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, the cry rang out, "Here's the bridegroom! Come out to meet him!" Then all the virgins woke up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, our lamps are going out." "No," they replied, "there may not be enough for both us and you. Instead, go to those who sell oil and buy some for yourselves." But while they were on their way to buy the oil, the bridegroom arrived. The virgins who were ready went in with him to the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later the others also came. "Sir, sir," they said, "open the door for us." But he replied, "I tell you the truth, I don't know you. Therefore, keep watch, because you don't know the day or the hour."
Amen.
Amen.
Итак, тема моего послания к вашей церкви в это воскресенье называется «Неразумное дело».
So like I say, the title of my message today to your church is Unwise Virgins.
И первый вопрос.
So the very first question to you.
Относится ли эта притча сегодня к церкви?
Do you think that this parable has a parallel to the church today?
Amen.
Я верю, что она относится к церкви.
I believe so.
Amen.
Кто такие девы?
Because who are those virgins?
Это церковь Иисуса Христа.
I believe virgins is the church of Jesus Christ.
Это ты и я.
Virgins is you and me.
Библия называет Иисуса женихом.
Bibles have a scripture saying that Jesus is our bridegroom.
Можем ли мы это подтвердить Писанием?
And I can confirm it to you now.
Давайте мы посмотрим 2 Коринфянам.
Let's see 2 Corinthians, Corinthians chapter 11. And we're going to read verse 2. Paul saying, "I'm jealous for you with a godly jealousy. I promised you to one husband to Christ, so that I might present you as a pure virgin to him."
Amen.
Amen.
Библия называет церковь чистой девой.
You know, Paul said that the church is must be A pure virgin to him.
Чистое дело.
Pure virgin.
Amen.
Amen.
Эта притча говорит о последнем времени.
And I believe this parable that Jesus told to his disciples was about last days, about the end of the days, about rapture of the church. Yes.
Кто-то верит в воскресение церкви?
If you believe in the rapture, the rapture will take place.
Иисус предупреждал.
Jesus warned his disciples.
Что будут двое на постели?
He said that night two will lay on the bed.
Один берется, один оставляется.
One will be taken, the other will left. That's
right. Будут двое на поле.
He said two gonna work in the field that day.
Один берется, один оставляется.
One will be taken and the other will left.
Друзья, мы живем последнее время.
Friends, we are living in the end of the day.
Если хорошенько наблюдать, что происходит в мире.
And if we gonna check it out for ourselves, what going on today in this world?
Что происходит сегодня в Израиле?
If you gonna check it out, what's going on today in Israel?
Что сегодня происходит в Сирии?
Or what's going on today in Syria?
Что происходит в Европе?
What's happening today in Europe?
Что происходит в России, в Украине?
What's going on today between Ukraine and Russia?
Что происходит сегодня в Америке?
What's going on even here today in the United States?
Иисус возвращается.
Hey, looking all these things, facing it to face, we can tell definitely that Jesus is coming back.
Иисус возвращается.
Jesus is about to come back.
И девы должны приготовить себя.
And the virgins must prepare themselves.
Итак,
the bridegroom.
Итак, мы вернемся к этой притче.
So let's be back to this parable.
Написано, что все девы вышли навстречу.
Jesus said that he mentioned that all that virgins they went out to meet bridegroom.
Я верю, что все девы были одинаково одеты.
And I believe that they all were dressed in the same way.
Это сейчас все женщины одеты по-разному.
You know, today we can see that women they prefer to have different kind of clothing.
Все по-разному одеты.
They close it in a different way, even here.
Но в древнем Израиле.
But if we going back to that days of Israel,
все девы одевались одинаково.
They all were dressed in the same way.
И невеста одевается в белое платье.
And especially virgins or brides, you know, even today they prefer to wearing white dressing.
Amen. Невеста одевает белое платье.
The brides usually have a white dressing.
Это символ чистоты и святости.
Because it's a sign of holiness, of purity.
И так они вышли все навстречу.
So you know they all went out to meet their bridegroom.
Они были все одинаково одеты.
They all were dressed in the same way.
У них в руках были лампы.
And they all had that lamps in their hands.
И Библия говорит.
And Bible says.
Что жених замедлил.
That the bridegroom was a long time in coming.
Обычно в еврейской традиции,
you know, it's usual and typical for Jewish tradition.
Жених приходил вечером 6-7 вечера.
Bridegroom that day is what is usual for bridegroom to arrive around 6 or 7 p.m. in the evening.
Но здесь написано, жених замедлил.
But here Jesus mentioned, and I believe for a reason, that the bridegroom was a long time in coming.
И Библия говорит в 5 стихе.
And so verse 5 says.
И как жених замедлил, то задремали все девы и уснули.
In the fifth verse says, the bridegroom was a long time in coming, and they all became drowsy and fell asleep.
О чем это говорит сегодня мне и тебе?
So what it tells today to us, to me and you?
Это говорит о том, что перед приходом Иисуса Христа.
I believe Jesus was trying to warn his church that right before his second coming,
будет сонное состояние церкви.
The church will get to that drowsy and sleepy condition.
Церковь расслабится перед приходом Христа.
The church will relax just before his second return.
Верующие будут очень заняты.
The Christian people they're gonna be very busy that day.
Семья.
You know they're gonna be busy with number of things, like was there a family?
Работа.
Was there a job?
Отдых.
They're gonna be busy with their even vacation time.
Любимый спорт.
Was their favorite sporting?
Любимое хобби.
You know, or different kind of hobbies like fishing and
друзья.
Hunting. Just having fun with their friends.
Телевидение.
Watching TV.
Интернет.
Spending lots of time in internet.
Верующие будут очень заняты.
No, the Christians are gonna be very busy.
У них не будет времени на Бога.
They, you know what? They're not gonna have enough of time for their God anymore.
У них не будет времени на молитву.
They're not gonna have enough of time for prayer life.
У них не будет времени на Библию.
They're not gonna have enough of time to read the Bible that day.
У них не будет времени ходить в церковь.
They're not gonna have enough of time to attend the church on a regular basis that day.
Смотрите, что сегодня происходит.
Just watch around. What's happening? What's going on these days in the world?
Многие церкви сегодня не обсудили недели служения.
Many churches they cancel their midweek services.
Многие отменили вечернее служение.
Many other churches they cancel their Sunday night services.
Многие старые верующие вспоминают, как было раньше.
And the elder believers, you know, they're reminding how it works in their days, when they were young.
Как раньше горели для Бога.
Like how in fireful we were for God in my young ages.
Как раньше молились.
Oh, what kind of heart and fireful prayers we had, we used to have in our church. What kind of fireful worship we used to have in our church before? Or what kind of conventions and conferences we used to have in our church? And how much in fireful our youth people were for God 10, 20, 30 years ago. And how much it has been changed now. How much it all has been changed now. Church getting to that drowsy condition. Many people, it doesn't have any more time to attend the church even on Sunday morning. You know, where are the gifts of the Holy Spirit? Where are the prophecies? The power and the signs, casting out the demons. You know, some churches, they even prefer to stop praying in tongues. Those people, they're just leaving the services. Dead virgins, they fell asleep. They had a drowsy condition and they're already sleeping now. And Bible says that the bridegroom arrived at the midnight. So what is the midnight?
Полночь это не вечер и не утро.
You know, midnight is not an evening and it's not early morning.
Полночь это самая тьма.
Midnight is a full, it's a time of full darkness.
И о какой полночи говорит Библия?
And you know what is the midnight that Jesus told us?
О духовной полночи.
I believe he was talking about spiritual midnight.
О греховной полночи.
He was talking about midnight of the sin.
Когда греховная тьма покроет землю.
Well, this darkness of the sin will cover entire of this world.
Беззаконие, разврат.
When this anxiety, you know, these perversions will cover the world.
Гомосексуализм, однополые браки.
When homosexuality, one sex marriage and all different kind of
pornography,
different kind of addiction, alcoholism, all these kind of things completely will cover the world.
Разврат по телевидению.
You know, when this TV will be filled with perversion, society, when the internet is a
horrible
place to walk, you know, when this society will be filled with anxiety.
Полная тьма.
Full darkness.
И в эту тьму.
And at the time, at the very time of that full darkness,
Господь помощь.
Jesus will come back.
Когда его никто не будет ждать.
At that moment when nobody will expect his second.
И Библия говорит, что девы они заснули.
And Jesus said that all that virgins they fell asleep.
Но раздался крик.
But when the ring was, you know, shouted out.
И для меня до сих пор загадка, откуда крик, кто закричал.
It's kind of question for me even today. Whose voice rang out? The bridegroom is coming.
И Библия говорит, что девы проснулись.
But Jesus said that all the virgins they woke up that moment.
И теперь вопрос, что отличало этих дев?
So now I have a question to you. What was the main difference between those virgins?
Кто из них был мудрый, кто неразумный?
Like who was wise and who was foolish?
Они все вышли навстречу.
Because they were very similar. You know, they first of all they all went out to meet bridegroom.
Они все были одинаково одеты.
They all were dressed in the same way.
У них всех были светильники.
They all had that lamps in their hands.
Все они все заснули.
More than that, they all fell asleep.
Что же их отличало?
So what was the difference between first and second?
И Библия говорит.
You know, and Bible says.
Что их отличало?
Jesus telling us what was the difference.
У мудрых было масло.
The wise virgins they had the oils in their jars.
У мудрых было масло в сосудах.
They had that oil in their jars.
Amen.
Amen.
Что такое масло?
So what is the oil?
Что такое масло?
What is the oil?
Масло это помазание Духа Святого.
Oil. I believe that is anointing of Holy Spirit.
Это сила Божья.
Power of God.
Церковь нам нужно помазание.
Because church need that anointing and power of God.
Нам нужны дары Духа Святого.
We need that gift of the Spirit.
Нам нужен огонь Духа Святого.
We need that fire of Spirit.
Нам нужна сила Божья.
We need that power of God.
Чтобы больные исцелялись.
For the sick people to be healed.
Чтобы бесы уходили.
For the demons to go out, to be cast out.
Чтобы пророческое слово.
For the prophecy to be in our churches.
Amen.
Take place in our churches.
Масло это помазание.
Oil is anointing in our churches.
Amen.
Amen.
И так мудрых и немудрых отличало масло.
So that was the difference between foolish and wise. The oil.
Amen.
Amen.
И мы дальше читаем.
And when we're reading this parable.
Немудрые говорят, дайте нам вашего масла.
We can see Jesus mentioned that these foolish, they ask wise, give us some of your oil.
Дайте нам вашего масла.
Give us some of your oil.
Знаете, что это такое?
Do you know what is that?
Если у вас вопрос.
I want to ask you something.
Если у вас такие верующие,
I have a question. Do you have or have you ever heard or have you ever seen that Christians,
которые приходят в церковь только тогда, когда у них проблемы,
who coming to the church only at the times of troubles in their life?
Well, come on.
Когда все хорошо.
You know, because whenever they feel good.
Семья, работа,
whenever they
деньги,
have perfect situation in their family, their marriage, with their money,
financially,
they would probably come to the church only for some special events.
Но когда проблема,
but once they get into trouble,
болезнь,
like trouble of sickness,
проблема в браке,
or some kind of problem with their marriage,
проблема с детьми,
or some problem with their kids,
финансовая проблема,
some financial
проблема с банком,
you know, problem with their bank,
другие проблемы,
some kind of different other problems.
Эти люди уже в церкви.
Once they get into the problem, they immediately come into the church.
Yeah. И они приходят,
you know, they come into the church.
Я говорю, помолитесь за меня.
And they say, oh, please pray for me.
Пожалуйста, помолитесь за меня.
Brothers and sisters, please. Please pray for
me. Проблема.
Keep praying for me because I got this problem. I have a problem with my children. My son, he became addicted of drugs. My daughter, she left our house. She lived in some other place.
I have
a sickness recently in my body. Brothers and sisters, please pray for me. Please, sister, pray for me.
У меня проблема.
I got this problem.
Дай мне твоего масла.
Please give me some of your oil.
Брат, помолись за меня.
Brother, pray for me.
Дай мне твоего масла.
Give me some of your oil.
Пастор, дорогой.
Pastor, dear pastor.
Пожалуйста,
please put your hand on me. Amen. Pray for me. I got a problem. I got sickness.
Дай мне твоего масла.
Please give me some of your oil.
Но когда все хорошо.
But you know, whenever they solve or fix their situation.
Пастор звонит.
Then pastor calling him again. Sister, why you was absent today in the church? Why you wasn't in the church? Oh dear pastor.
Я очень busy.
I am so busy.
Я очень busy.
I'm so much busy.
У меня две работы.
I have two jobs.
У меня надо в gym ходить.
And I'm practicing in gym to lose some weight.
У меня вечером любимый сериал.
And in the evening time when you have your church service, I'm watching my favorite TV show.
У меня некогда.
I really doesn't really have a time. I'm very busy.
Брат, почему ты не приходишь в воскресенье?
Pastor calling to brother, why you wasn't in the church this Sunday?
О, пастор дорогой.
Oh dear pastor.
Я очень busy.
I'm very busy.
Очень busy.
It's a hunting season.
Мне нужно работать.
And I need to work, you know.
И мы с друзьями идем на фишинг.
And next Sunday I'm probably gonna go with my friends for a fishing.
А еще следующий.
And then after that we're gonna have a hunting again.
И я busy.
And I'm busy, you know.
Но когда проблема?
But you know what? Once he gets into the trouble.
Sister, помолись за меня.
Please pray for me.
Дай мне твоего масла.
Give me some of your oil.
Брат, помолись за меня.
Give me some of your oil. Pray for me. Because I got this sickness.
О, сестра, помолись за меня.
Sister, you also pray for me.
Дай мне масло твоего.
Give me some of your oil.
Но когда все хорошо.
And once he feeling better, then he busy again.
Yeah, busy.
No, I'm very busy.
Yeah.
This sentence in America. And I really like this sentence here.
Оно называется "Я very busy". I'm very busy.
I'm very busy.
I'm very busy.
Many people
are
very busy.
Я запомню это слово.
I will remember. I will memorize this saying here in America. I'm very busy.
Но когда проблема?
So you know, when they got to the problem.
Люди в церкви.
They are coming to the church immediately.
Помолитесь.
Oh, pray for me.
Дайте мне вашего масла.
Give me some of your oil.
Amen. И дальше Библия говорит.
And then Jesus said.
Когда мудрые не поделились маслом.
Because wise they didn't give they didn't share their oil with these foolish virgins.
То Библия говорит в 10 стихе.
And then in the 10th verse.
Когда же они пошли покупать?
We can read 10 verse. It says, but while they were on their way to buy the oil,
когда они пошли покупать,
while they were on their way to buy the
oil. А теперь внимательно послушай.
I want you to pay attention to this.
За масло нужно платить цену.
I want to tell you something, and I want you to pay attention. You must pay the price for the oil.
Я сказал, за масло нужно платить цену.
You must pay the price for the oil.
За масло нужно платить.
to have that oil in your jar, you must pay the price. It's, you know, it's the price of your dedication, your prayers, your fasting time. You must pay the price for that oil. If you are busy, you probably will never gain that oil to your jar.
Поэтому нужно ходить в Дом Божий.
So that's why you better come to the church.
Необходимо проводить время с ним.
You better attend the time, attend the church, and you better spend more of your personal valuable time with him.
Нужно платить цену.
Because you may pay the price.
Ты сегодня пришел сюда.
You are here today.
Ты уже заплатил цену.
You already paid the price of your valuable time.
Ты мог бы остаться дома.
You may sit in your home.
Смотреть телевизор.
Just watch TV today in the morning.
Пойти к друзьям.
Or just come and visit your friends, your family.
Где-то погулять.
Just spend time with your family, taking a walk somewhere in the city.
Но ты пришел сюда.
But you are here.
Ты потратил свое время.
You're giving, investing your valuable time.
Ты потратил топливо на транспорт.
You even spend, you know, you gave the oil from your tank, from your car.
Ты принес пожертвование.
You gave some offerings today.
Amen. Ты потратил время.
You gave your time.
И это плата за масло.
And that's all the price for the oil.
Когда ты дома находишь время на молитву,
you know,
на слово.
And there is another option to gain that oil whenever you sitting in your secret room, in your home, spending time reading the Bible and in the prayer to Him.
Ты платишь цену.
You're paying the price, the same price for that oil.
Ты бы за это время мог бы что-то сделать на работе.
Because you could spend that time in million of different ways.
Ты за это время мог бы что-то дома сделать.
You could fix something in your home there for that time.
Ты за это время мог бы посидеть в интернете, в Фейсбуке.
You could just either watch some movie or just spend the time in internet or Facebook.
Да, но ты платишь цену.
But you decide, you prefer to give the price of
ты
your
time. Ты стоишь на своих коленях.
To bow your knees.
Yeah. Ты молишься Богу.
To pray God.
Ты читаешь Библию.
To read His word.
Это ты платишь цену за масло.
That is also the price for that oil.
Amen. Hallelujah.
You better pay the price for that oil now. And I want you to pay attention to
this.
For Jesus said, when they came back,
жених зашел, и мудрые девы зашли
the bridegroom and that five wise virgins, they were already in that banquet hall.
Banquet.
That foolish virgins, they started knocking the door to that banquet, wedding banquet.
И они говорят, открой нам.
They're asking, Sir, open the door for us.
Мы ходили в церковь.
Sir, we attended the church.
Когда было время.
Sometimes when I had a time, I attended the church.
А так мы были busy.
When I wasn't so busy, I was in the church.
Мы давали десятину.
And I even gave my tithes.
Иногда.
Few times, sometimes, not all the time.
И что они услышали?
So what they hear back?
Они услышали, я не знаю вас. Я не знаю вас. Я что-то скажу сейчас. Некоторое время назад.
You know, some time ago, I want to give you an example. Some time ago.
Зазвенел мой телефон.
I had an incoming call.
Я смотрю незнакомый номер.
And I realized that it was unknown number.
И я говорю, алло.
So I decided to answer. I said, hello.
И мне говорят, пастор, это Билл.
And the voice there said, pastor, hello, this is Bill.
Что за Билл, я не знаю.
And I was like, Bill, who are you?
Я хожу в вашу церковь.
And he said, hey, pastor, I was in your church.
Я говорю, я не знаю тебя.
I was like, but I don't know you. Who are you?
Ну, я очень редко прихожу, я очень busy.
And he said, well, pastor, I'm not coming to your church on a regular basis, but sometimes I'm coming, well, sometimes because I'm busy.
Ну, на каждый праздник прихожу.
But for special events, I'm coming to the church.
И мне нужно было 5 минут.
So, you know, it took 5 minutes.
Чтобы понять, кто
for
это
me
человек.
To understand who he is.
И я потом вспомнил, Билл,
and then he was hardly trying to describe how he looks like and you know what age he is. And then I realized, okay, now I think I understand.
Его голос был мне неизвестен.
No, his voice wasn't similar to me.
Вы улавливаете мысль?
Can you catch what I'm saying?
Yes,
но когда звонит мой друг,
but you know what? If my friend John calling to me,
я даже не смотрю на номер.
I don't even have to watch who is calling to me. To check it out.
Hello, и он говорит, hi,
and even if he's calling from another phone number,
awesome
answer, he's saying, hello, pastor. I'm saying, hello, John, how are you?
Теперь послушай очень внимательно.
разница?
What is the difference between these two colors?
Yeah. Потому что я с Джоном провожу время.
I'm spending the time with the second one, with John.
Yes. Мы с ним дружим.
We are in a friendship with him.
Мы имеем отношения.
We have good relation with him.
Мы с ним вместе отдыхаем.
We're spending time together. Uh-huh. We're having some rest together with him.
We're
drinking coffee with him. Yeah. We're having dinner with
him. Мы много общаемся по телефону.
You know, we're spending lots of time in the fellowship with
the Lord. Я прихожу к нему в гости.
You know, sometimes I'm coming to his home as a guest.
Он приходит ко мне в гости.
Sometimes he's attending me in my home as a guest.
Я знаю его голос.
I know his voice.
Я знаю его голос.
I know his voice.
Не мудрые девы пришли.
And that foolish virgins, they arrived at the door.
Они стучали в
дверь. Saying, "Sir, sir, open the door for us."
Но он не знал их ни голос.
But he didn't know their voice.
О чем это сегодня говорит тебе и мне?
What he tells today to you and me?
Он не просто хочет быть твоим
you
Богом.
You know, he don't want just to be your God.
Он не просто хочет быть твоим спасителем.
He don't want just to be your Savior only.
Он не просто хочет быть твоим господином.
And he don't want just to be your Lord.
Uh-huh. Он не просто хочет быть твоим целителем.
Not to be just your healer.
Uh-huh. Он не просто хочет быть твоим защитником.
Not just to be your protector.
Uh-huh. Он хочет быть твоим другом.
He wants to be your friend, first of all.
Он хочет иметь с тобой отношения.
He wants to have that close relation with you.
Он хочет встречаться с тобой.
He wants to meet you face to face in your secret room.
У меня вопрос к тебе сегодня.
And I want to ask you today a question.
Проводишь ли ты время с Богом?
Do you spend your time, your precious valuable time with your God in prayer and reading His Word?
Если у тебя время на встречу с Ним.
Do you give your precious time to meet Him face to face?
Если у тебя время на молитву ли?
Do you have your personal prayer in your secret room?
Или ты очень busy?
Or are you too much busy today for
prayer? У тебя нету времени на молитву.
And you have no time for prayer.
У тебя нету времени читать Библию.
And you have no time to read the Bible.
У тебя нету времени ходить в церковь.
And you have no time even to attend the church.
Ты очень busy.
Because you're very busy with all different kind of things.
У меня вопрос к тебе.
I have a question to you today.
Знает ли он твой голос?
Does he know your voice or no?
Ответь себе честно.
Just be honest with yourself first of all and ask yourself, does he know my voice or not?
Знает ли он твой голос?
Does he know my voice?
Не скажешь ли он тебе, я не знаю твой голос?
What he will respond to you will or he will say, I don't know you.
Господь, открой мне твоя невеста.
Lord, open the door for us. I'm in the number of your brides.
Мы тоже вышли навстречу.
I was on my way to meet you, the same as the others.
Мы одели белые одежды.
And I am dressed in the same way as the other people.
Мы тоже взяли светильники.
And I also had a lamp in my hand.
И те девы тоже спали.
And you all know what? When I slept, they also slept.
Вы говорите, я не знаю ваших голосов.
But he said, hey, I can't recognize your voice.
Wow. Господи, я ходил 10 лет в церковь.
Lord, I attended the church for 10 years. I attended the Father's Heart Ministry 10 years.
Пастор знает меня.
And pastor probably knows him, knows me.
Он говорит, я не знаю твой голос.
But he said, but I don't know your voice.
Ты не проводил время со мной в молитве.
You never spent your time within a prayer.
Ты был очень-очень-очень занят.
You were very, very, very much busy.
Ты находил время на все.
You know what? You had enough of time for all the things in your life.
Ты находил время на работу.
Different kind of things, like your job.
Ты находил время на семью.
Your family.
Ты находил время на gym.
Had time for your gym.
Ты находил время на охоту, рыбалку.
Sporting, for fishing, for hunting.
Ты находил время на телевизор.
You had time to watch TV.
Ты находил время на интернет.
You had time for internet.
Ты находил время пообщаться с друзьями.
You had time for fellowship with your friends.
Но для меня у тебя не было времени.
Unfortunately, you never had time to talk to me.
Я не знаю твой голос.
I don't know your voice.
Друзья, сегодня Дух Божий говорит тебе.
Friends, this is the Spirit of God who is talking to you today.
Начни проводить время с Ним.
You gotta spend time with your God.
Начни платить цену.
Pay the price of your oil.
И тогда помазание будет приходить.
Pay the price for that oil and then that anointing will come to your life.
Когда ты проводишь время с Ним.
For when you're spending your time with Him.
В церкви.
In the church.
Дома.
In your home.
В твоей личной комнате.
In your secret personal room.
Он знает твой голос.
Then he getting to know your voice.
И когда ты платишь цену.
And when you're paying that price,
твой сосуд наполняется
time,
маслом.
Then you're getting that oil to your jar.
Масло yeah. твой сосуд наполняет.
Jar is coming and just pouring into your oil. To
масло
your,
твой сосуд наполняет, и ты становишься мудрой девой.
And you know you're getting to be a wise virgin.
И он знает твой голос.
And he getting to know your voice.
У меня снова вопрос к тебе.
And I'm gonna ask you once again.
Знает ли он твой голос?
Does he knows your voice?
Просто сам себе ответь.
Just ask yourself, given honest answer for yourself.
То, что ты ходишь в церковь, это хорошо.
The fact that you're attending the church is very good.
Это очень хорошо.
That's very important.
То, что ты даешь десятину, это очень хорошо.
Giving your tithes and you're faithful with that is very important. It's very
good. Но знает ли он твой голос?
But there is another very important question.
Если у тебя личная встреча с ним,
do you have your secret room praying in your home, paying the tithe,
paying the price of your tithe,
talking to your God? Just think about this today.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Поэтому сегодня я хочу молиться за тебя.
And that's why I wanna pray for you today.
Yes.
Чтобы Дух Божий коснулся тебя.
The Spirit of God to touch you.
Yes.
Чтобы сегодня Бог проговорил к тебе.
For God to speak to your life today.
И чтобы с сегодняшнего дня.
And may starting from today.
Yes. Даже если ты сильно busy.
Even if you're really busy.
Ты находил время.
Just make sure that you have at least some time
in
your busy daily schedule to spend time with Him.
В слове,
in reading the Word,
и в молитве,
and having personal prayer.
Чтобы ты платил цену.
For you to pay, for you to make sure
чтобы
to that you pay the price of that oil, for your jar to be filled
давайте
with that oil.
Встанем.
Let us sit on our feet.
Yeah. Пожалуйста, все встанем на свои ноги.
Please.
Давайте мы все поднимем свои руки к Нему.
Raise our hands up to heaven.
К нашему жениху.
To our dear bridegroom.
Он скоро грядет.
He is about to come back.
Jesus come back.
He is about to be back.
И это будет очень скоро.
And that is going to be very soon.
И сегодня Дух Божий говорит к тебе.
And today Spirit of God is speaking to you.
Посмотри в свой сосуд.
Hey, check it out. Check your jar for yourself.
Yes.
Проверь свой сосуд.
Is there an oil or is empty?
Есть ли там масло?
Is there an oil?
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Есть ли там масло? Платишь ли ты цену?
Do you pay the price?
Проводишь ли ты время с Ним?
Do you spending your time with your God?
Дух Божий коснись сейчас каждого.
Spirit of God, touch each and everyone in this room.
Пройдись по этим рядам, по этому залу, по этой
just
комнате.
Walk around in this sanctuary. Touch everyone.
Все закроем свои глаза.
Close your eyes, everyone here in this sanctuary. Close your eyes.
Дух Божий коснись сейчас.
Spirit of God, I pray you, I ask you to touch everyone in this room.
Yes, Lord.
Дай покаяние.
Repentance to those who need it.
Пошли обличение.
And just speak to their hearts.
Коснись каждого сердца.
Touch each and every heart in this.
Чтобы каждый сделал решение.
For everyone to make the sincere decision.
С этого дня.
Starting from today.
Начать платить цену.
To pay the price.
За масло.
For the oil.
Чтобы быть мудрой девой.
For everyone is to be in the kind of wise virgins.
Теперь послушай, если ты чувствуешь, что Бог говорил к тебе.
And you know what? If you feel like God has spoke to you today.
И тебе нужно масло.
And that you're the one who need the oil.
Я попрошу тебя выйти вперед.
If you feel that, I want you to come closer here to altar.
Я хочу особенную молитву совершить за тебя.
I want to make a special prayer for you.
И Бог коснется тебя.
And God is going to touch you.
Во имя Иисуса Христа.
In Jesus' name.
Если ты чувствуешь, выходи вперед.
If you feel like this was for you and
не стесняйся.
Need that oil.
Поднимай свои руки, закрывай глаза.
Just don't be ashamed of this.
Аллилуйя, сейчас Дух Святой будет касаться тебя.
Raise your hands up. Close your eyes. And
я попрошу пастора, пожалуйста, подыграй на кибер.
Pastor, can I ask you to help us play on the keyboard?
Аллилуйя, аллилуйя, аллилуйя. Дух Святой, Дух Святой, Дух Святой, Дух Святой.
Holy Spirit.
Урабе да фолгребе да сандо. Шиба ба 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 ка кура ба на ба санду ла ба ба бу шила. Урро бо сумбра ба 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 контре бе шила ба кара ма санду ла ба бу шиба. Лебра ба ла ба сандо. Если ты крещен Духом Святым, начни молиться на иных языках. Все, кто крещены Духом Святым сейчас в этой комнате, возвысьте ваши голоса, молясь Духом Святым. Помазание будет сходить. Помазание будет сходить. Помазание будет течь по твоей голове. Yes, 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 yes